So the person I need to talk to, prescribed Rothschild, was at the downstairs of the lab.
I am sorry for your loss. I was acquainted with your father many years ago.
He sounds so unenthusiastic.
One of its few remaining visionaries.
Thanks for your sympathy. How did you know my father?
I have been a part of the Brotherhood for many years. Enough that I was here when Project Purity first began. I did not work directly with your father. He and his team valued their independence, and I respected that.
Thank you. Yeah, whatever. Are you going to help me or not?
Taking the loss in stride, are we? It would seem the Brotherhood has more pressing matters to attend to than a 20-year-old defunct project. Out of respect for your father, however, I will offer advice. What exactly do you need?
I need to find a Gek.
Really? A pity. You won't find one here. It may be possible to locate one, however.
So you know how to find one?
Possibly. I'm afraid I won't be able to assist you directly. The news Dr. Lee has brought will require me to be elsewhere. I can, however, give you access to an old pre-war computer from Vault-Tec. It may have the information you need. You will find the terminal in the archives in the A-Ring.
The A-Ring. Thanks for some help.
You are welcome.
Alright, let's go find the A-Ring. I believe it's this way. Up the stairs. Look at the logo for Brotherhood of Steel. It's interesting. Or at least that's what I think the logo is about. There's two things I need to do in the A-Ring. Find the Bailey to get my power armor training so that I can finally use that. Because I killed a lot of outcast soldiers.
Need something? What aid can I offer you, outsider?
You must see a lot of things. What's been going on? Can someone in the Citadel train me? Any thoughts in the Enclave?
As if we didn't have enough to worry about. Their weapons are better. Their power armor is better. Is their training better? We'll see.
Yeah, I wonder how that happened. I have to go now. Okay. Old pre-war computer. This is the B-Wing. B-Ring, I don't want to go to the B-Ring. This is a huge complex. Huge complex. Crate. Super sugar bombs. Snack cakes. I like to take all these to sell them. They're not bad money. I'm over encumbered again. Damn it. I took care of the over encumberedness. I'm gonna have to sell these. I mean, sell a lot of stuff. Damn it! So I guess I can't take any more items. So I'll just drop, turpentine. It's 2-8. Just drop some food, because food is like the least important thing. Like mac and cheese, don't need that.
Does this sound noble enough?
Oh, what the hell happened there? There we go. Whoa. What is this place? This place is insane. Good thing that ammo doesn't weigh anything. What is? What the hell? Just am confused where to go right now. I think that's the computer.
Welcome.
Mason family dossier, state of museum diary. Is that something I need to look into? Roger Mason, second in command of the war secretary from the top grade research. Assumed command after nervous breakdown. Security team member learning their research info for a lot of revolutionary virus. Deserted from military just before the war. Mixon ordered the families of all base personnel brought inside the family, thereby sparing their lives. The survivor is in their exodus, and the last, however, mission was killed and the journey. At last kills Bowser Mason earned from the Brotherhood of Steel, his organization's first high leader. Oh, so he's like the first guy. This is too much. Diary of Markson. Dang, that's a lot. I, Roger Markson, captain, serial number, blah blah blah, started this log because it doesn't look good for any of us, and I like for people to know what really happened here. All hell broke loose when we finally discovered that those scientists were up to. The colonel has locked himself in his office and seems to be having some sort of breakdown. The men are screaming for blood. They're looking for me in answers, and I'm not sure what it is. Someone has to do something, though, before the place sinks into an anarchistic bloodbath. Let's look at the last. So, I finally reply to the outside world over our radio. I don't know why they never sent messages here, anyone here, to see what was happening when we started responding to their transmissions. Doesn't make any sense. Well, they'll come now. I declared ourselves seceded from the Union. They remember Jefferson Davis. What will history say about me? Interesting. I hope I don't have to read all that.
The Enclave seems to have you just managed to get yourself into all. Well.
Oh. I have to go now. Yeah, I hope that's not the computer it's mentioning.
The Enclave.
Unless it is. I guess I'll read through it all that. But I won't record it because it's just boring to you guys. So there was another computer that, that girl, Lyons was using. And this computer, Vault 87 information, that's the thing to get, I guess. There's all these different equipments and stuff. And I believe the GEC is in Vault 87, right? I still need to talk to that one guy to get my power armor training. But I can't find him anywhere. Yeah, this time for sure the game froze on me again. I'm really thinking this has to do with the disc. So I probably have to get another Fallout 3 disc or something, because if this keeps continuing, this is going to mess up my PS3. My PS3 has green light, so it's definitely not the yellow light of Doom or whatever. Anyway, that's that. I just wanted to say this part was interesting. I get to explore the history of the war that happened, the nuclear war that happened. Apparently, the first dropping of the atomic bomb was on October 7, 2077. And the reason is because, like, the Chinese soldiers invaded Anchorage or some of that. So the war was between the United States and China. And the United States was planning, actually, to win the war by building this gigantic, the most powerful robot, which talks, walks, the most powerful robot ever built. That was their plan, apparently, in one of the historical documents they read. And regarding the John Maxon diaries, I read them all. And so the deal is that he was stuck in a room with a group of scientists, and the scientists were following orders, or they said they were following orders, doing inhuman experiments, and Jonathan Maxon didn't believe it, so he killed one of them, and that cycle continued, so that, like, the whole group of scientists were killed. He killed his superior because he just went berserk and went out of control, so he became the leader. And he declared himself eventually succeeded from the United States government, but nothing happened. The United States government didn't respond, so he didn't understand, and so he just left the place after the atomic bombs dropped, on China and stuff, which is interesting. Like,
you want to talk to Spry? Oh,
Jameson. Whoa!
She's the Archivist.
It didn't freeze. Oh, cool. Oh, I thought it was gonna freeze. All right, that was interesting. So that took me like 20 minutes. So I guess the good thing is to just keep it on.
Indeed I can. Pay no heed to those headstrong knights. It is the scribes who make the Brotherhood what it truly is. The brawn is useless without the brain. Each order of scribes is dedicated to a unique field. All
And the order are?
Order of the Sword, Order of the Shield, Order of the Quill, Weapons, Defenses, and Research, respectively.
Let me guess, you belong to the Order of the,
Sword, of course. Weapons, my girl. You name it, I've helped someone kill it. I'm the proctor of the Order of the Sword, you see? Weapons research, development, and maintenance, all my responsibility.
Interesting, that's all I needed. This guy's kind of boring to talk to, so that's it. And I guess I'll end it at this video. And the next video I'll actually head somewhere instead of just exploring around the Citadel, which makes for a boring playthrough, honestly.